Hey, Green, we've been chatting about the new sensors on the ship and wondering what gets you excited about the data.
I think for me personally, and from like a data perspective, the ability that I'm hoping to help create on this new vessel to better integrate the information from a variety of sensors into one place and hopefully have more analysis-ready data that a scientist could pull and look at information, not just from one sensor at a time, but multiple sensors, for me personally, is an exciting goal to have.
When we talk about a sensor or a sensor system, we're using that as a broad term for a scientific instrument that is either directly or indirectly taking some type of measurement. One sensor system may actually be measuring multiple different types of information. For example, one of the meteorological sensors that will be on board Falkor 2, a MetPack Pro, measures wind speed, wind direction, air pressure, air temperature, and humidity. We will also have about 18 other types of oceanographic sensors. On top of that, we have 6 or 7 navigational sensors, which relay information related to the ship's position, heading, attitude, and the speed of the vessel. We then connect that location-based data to the information coming from the other sensors so that we can know for sure where each bit of data we gather is situated in time and space. We'll be starting out with about 30 different types of oceanographic, navigational, and atmospheric sensor systems on the vessel itself. The remote-operated vehicle Sebastian has its own suite of similar sensors. For both quality and accuracy purposes, though, we actually may have duplicate instruments running at various locations on the ship. So in total, we'll have more actual instruments aboard.
So part of what's really exciting of this new refit is that we're putting a large foremast and a larger mainmast on the ship. And both of these spaces allow us to put an increased number of sensors aboard right now as we set sail, but we're also setting the stage to have a lot of additional room and ways to attach future sensors, some of which we don't even know what they're going to be yet, some of which don't even exist yet, but we're setting the platform to be able to keep us in good stead for decades to come.
We're building our data systems for Falkor 2 to allow us to not just collect all the data from the multitude of sensors on the ship, but visualize it in real time on the ship and perform real time quality assurance. We'll also be able to create ways for participants on land to see real time data. We even have high performance computing power available to scientists on board to allow modeling or other computationally intensive work to be done while at sea.
One of my favorite things about data is you can't know how the world around you is changing without understanding where it is first. And tracking what we have allows us to see where things are today so we can see what we can make better tomorrow.